challenged our guys after our first four conference games to get off to a better start. First four conference games, we dug ourselves too deep in the hole, and I was pleased with the way we started the game, both offensively and defensively. And Andy's got his kids playing really hard right now and defending at a high level. We knew it was going to be a challenge coming in. But I'm pleased with the way our guys executed the first half. And our challenge to our guys was to, you know, to take care of the ball and get a good shot down every time offensively. And that's where our woes were the first four games. And, you know, in the second half, we were able to kind of maintain and sustain that lead and you know, until a late surge there at the end. But ended up making enough plays and then squeaking one out. And, you know, it's certainly two programs right now that early in the league are playing well, and Andy's guys are playing well, and they battled back. We knew that was going to happen. And, you know, for us, we'll enjoy this one for the bus ride back to Loretto, but have a short-term memory and get ready for Mount on Saturday.
What was working so well about the pick and roll game, especially, you know, they didn't seem to adjust to it or couldn't slide to it down low in the place?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of things, you know, when you have guys, you know, with Jamal and Malik and Keith, you have multiple guys that can handle the basketball, and I think it becomes harder to lock onto one particular guy. And, you know, I thought our guys did a good job of spacing the floor. That's the other thing, is you can have, you know, a lot of screen and roll actions or even screening actions, but if your spacing is poor, those passes are a little harder to make and those lanes aren't as open. So I think the two guys that were engaged in the screening action did a good job of executing, but I think the other three guys spaced the floor well.
The three guards played really well tonight. You just speak to their performance. I mean, Jamal didn't play well late, but to have those three in your call for, 60-plus points?
Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, it makes my job a lot easier. When you call a play, everything looks good when the ball goes in. And those guys have spent a lot of time working on the game, and you know, offensively, when you can have three guys put up those kinds of numbers, you know, again, it's hard to key on one guy. And I thought we were able to score in a variety of ways. Didn't shoot the ball particularly well tonight, but we were able to score around the basket and make our free throws. So, you know, all three of those guys are good free throw shooters. You know, Keith's ability to rebound the basketball, you know, certainly, you know, allows us to be a little more creative in transition. But those three guys are, again, make my job a lot easier, because you can draw up a play, but the ball doesn't go in, you know, that play doesn't mean anything. They certainly did their part tonight.
You alluded to it, but it's a team that thrives on ball pressure. You only have 9 turnovers. You feel pretty good about that.
Yeah, it's something as a team we focused on all year. You know, we thought that if we could take care of the basketball and get good shots, regardless of our opponent, we put ourselves in a, you know, decent position. And you're able to set your defense a little bit better, and a lot of times turnovers turn into transition points. And, Robert Morris is really good at that, taking their turnovers and their steals and converting them. So we don't want to give them a running start offensively, and you know, that pressure becomes running good offense so that they can't get running downhill on us. And, you know, certainly something we've tried to harp on, but again, with multiple guys that can handle basketball, especially late game when fatigue is a factor, it helps to have that depth.
Your scoring rate and, you know, your offensive production over the course of the season, how do teams in the NEC typically try to defend you?
You know, I think it's a little early to figure that one out. We were 5 games in. You know, the one nice thing for us is, you know, it's not a one person show. You know, different guys have had big nights, and we've had a little bit of the injury bug here the last 2-3 weeks, and some guys have really stepped up and, play different roles, you know, so that helps too when you don't have the same guys doing the same thing every night. You have some guys that come off the bench, you know, Mark Fly came off the bench in our last game, they played really well. And guys like Scotty Meredith and now Randall Gaskins back in the lineup certainly give us some depth. So I think, you know, having multiple guys that can make plays, you know, as you alluded to earlier, it's kind of hard to key on one.
Kobe Thomas has been one of the best freshmen in the conference this year. Does a guy like that, who bounced even a little bit more opportunistic in how they, you know, see scoring opportunities, maybe a little bit tougher to game plan for?
Absolutely, because when that shot goes up, you can take a team out of a play. You know, okay, the ball's going to go here, or this person's going to get the ball, and you can do your best to try to take them out of the play. But when that shot goes up, all bets are off. You know, there's no play for that. And he does such a good job going and getting the rebound and finishing around the basket. He's an impressive freshman. You know, I made the comment to one of our guys, you know, when you score 13 points, he's averaging about 13 points a game right now. As a freshman in any league, that says something about, you know, you as a player. And I talked to Andy a little bit before the game, and his staff has done an unbelievable job of assembling young talent. And, you know, Kobe's one of those kids, and you know, a double-double tonight. I thought he played under control and, you know, brought a lot of great energy. And, you know, late in the second half, you know, we needed to match some of that energy because he was a handful.
For a team that's so young and inexperienced as Robert Morris, is it almost, I mean, you know Andy going battling against some words. The way they're playing this year, they're picked seventh in the league, but it's almost not as much of a surprise just because of the way you can coach.
Absolutely. I mean, Andy's a tremendous coach. And, you know, the one consistent, you know, with Andy's teams, you know, since he's been in the league, they play hard. They play really, really hard, and they make you earn everything. And, you know, the issue was a little bit last year with a really young team. And, you know, you'd like to speed the clock up and get those guys to be sophomores and juniors and seniors. But the only thing that, you know, at this point those guys can do is go through those experiences and learn, you know, from, you know, a play or a game and continue to build on that as sophomores and juniors and seniors. So, you know, the one thing those kids will do, they'll play hard for Andy. And, you know, through the first, you know, five games, they're really starting to score the ball too. And when they put those two things together, they're going to be, you know, for a couple of years here, they're going to be pretty good.
How much do you view this, or do you view this as a rivalry game?
I mean, anytime, I mean, geographically, you know, it's we're the two closest schools. And, you know, I know that for a while, you know, the rivalry, the Pittsburgh-Loretto rivalry, even when I played, you know, the games were highly contested. You know, one of the things, you could throw the records out the window, and there's so much familiarity with the two schools. I think you look at other sports too, you look at football and some of the other teams, women's basketball. You know, I know that, you know, our women and your women are going to be playing here on Saturday. So I think, you know, geographically, it's a natural rivalry. Over the course of the last, you know, 6 or 7 years, it's become one that, you know, the games are tough and hotly contested, and you know, they're fun to be in because those are the games that, as a competitor, you want to, the energy level and, you know, the opportunity to make plays and do it against, you know, a team like Robert Morris that has had a ton of success here.